All right, this is SSL Family Dad with Simple Suburban Living, and today I just wanted to give you kind of a tour of everything we're growing here and just kind of check out our messy garden and kind of explain what happened this year. So this has actually been the best garden we've ever had. It is a mess. And I come from a military background. I like things to be in a line. I like things to be, you know, dress right dress and kind of orderly. And sometimes with gardening, it's just not possible. So our garden has become a little bit of a mess, but we were on vacation this year. We're in the middle of selling our house. We've just been, things have been extraordinarily crazy around here. And we haven't had had the time to come out and guide things and tie up the tomatoes a little bit better and prune things and water as much as we needed to while we were gone and other things like that. And so there has been some things that have gone wrong and some things that have gone right. So I'm just going to kind of take you guys through the garden and show you the growth of what we have. Along the video here, I will link in the top to some related videos. You know, if you want to see kind of what the gardens looked like originally, some of the things we planted and why, the soil mix we're using, other things like that, click on that little eye in the upper corner there and you'll get a link to some related videos that will explain some of that. So without further ado, let's go ahead and dig in here. I'll just kind of give you guys a tour through and show you what we got. Okay, just to kind of give you a quick overview of everything that we're growing. This is kind of our back orchard area. We've talked about this. We're kind of doing like a back to Eden type thing. It really hasn't kicked into gear. It's only been 2 years that we've had these wood chips out here, and this is all just from this year, this whole area. And so it's not really working very well other than retaining moisture. It's been extremely dry this year, and this is also an area that doesn't get a lot of sunlight, or as much as the rest of the garden, I should say, about half as much. We've had some critters kind of tear up our giant pumpkin here. This was we were gone, like I said, on vacation, and our dog normally kind of keeps the bunnies and other things out of the yard, and the bunnies have come in and just really cleaned us this year, cleaned us out. But I've got a lot of trees back here. You can see the sunflowers are very small. Just things didn't grow very well back here. This is extra space. I just throw in extra seeds back here and just whatever happens, happens. As we go along the fence here, we've got some tomatoes. I never even got a chance to stake up this year. We've been so busy. The ones that are staked up are doing pretty well. That's a pretty decent little harvest on these littler tomato plants. I've got our little kiwis in here I planted this year. Blueberry bush that a rabbit just came by and chewed all to heck. Some tomatoes here as we get on the line, they get a little bigger. There's the other kiwi. I have two of those. And it looks like we've got some tomatoes ready on this one. Blueberry bush here, which is doing pretty well this year. And another blueberry over here, which I actually, those both did. This is the best we've had for blueberries out of those two. Sunflowers, you can see, are getting a little larger as we go down the fence line here. This is all grapes. Now, these grapes, I believe, are 2 years old. We planted them from just little sticks, and you can see how big the main stems are here. But there's three different varieties of grapes, and we just let them kind of grow all over the fence. You can see back there and over here. They're doing very well. They're loaded with grapes. You can see them everywhere in here. Just grapes everywhere. So I'm excited to give those a try this year. And then we get into the disaster, I like to call it. This is again, we're suburban farming here, so everything's very close together, and normally that means you have to tame some things down here and guide things to grow a certain way. Well, we didn't have a chance to do that this year since we've been gone and selling our house. And this is all raspberries and blackberries back here. They have just taken over this whole space, growing in and over the corn. In fact, we've got some growing in over here. Just turned into quite a forest. This is a literal food forest, you could say. The blackberries and raspberries have been awesome. The corn this year is the best we've ever had with corn. As you can see, this is about 10 feet tall, this corn. It was over 5 feet tall on the 4th of July. They always say, you know, knee high by the 4th of July. And this was double that or triple that. But we've had a little raccoon, a baby raccoon, which I've seen in our yard sneaking in this year. And it looks like it's enjoyed some of the corn, which is great. But there's plenty more for us, so we're not too sad. It looks like it got into a couple of them here. But there's lots more, and now that we're back home from vacation, the dog's out here throughout the day and evening, and most of those animals tend to stay away. So this year we let my three daughters pick out their own garden beds, and my youngest daughter wanted to grow these mini pumpkins. She saw these at the store and just had to have these in her garden. Well, these things have grown so well in the soil mix that we have here and everything. I mean, there are just literally probably 100 of these mini pumpkins. We've already harvested a lot of them. There's more to come. I'm just picking them out here as I go. Honestly, there's not a whole lot of use for these. You can cut them open. The chickens will eat them. I also think that these would be great pig food on our new farm. I could probably grow them along with fences and things, and then just drop them into the pig pastures. So they could be useful for something. They grow just crazy. We had planted, this is a little square foot garden. You can't even see it in here. There was about three or four of them, and they grew everywhere. There are vines going all the way into the garden. They're coming out here. You know, they're coming out over here. They're a good 20, 25 feet long in some locations. Over here we've got loofahs. Whatever else was in this garden, she planted some carrots and things. Again, I just let it go. And potatoes all in this area are ready to be harvested, actually, but now there's just weeds growing up. But the potatoes are in there, and so we'll get those out today. Loofahs over here. This is the first time I've ever tried a loofah. These beautiful yellow flowers, they're open in the morning. They're starting to wilt out now, but they're just huge yellow flowers, and the bees, our honeybees, just love them. I can see them all over these things early in the morning. And I can see in here that we've got some good size loofahs. I had no idea they grew this big, but there's quite a few of them in here, at least five or six of them that I could find so far, and they still seem to be growing, and so we're happy about that. Roma tomatoes, normally I would prune these and take care of them, but they just went wild, and there are tomatoes everywhere. There are probably 100 tomatoes just on this plant. It's crazy. We've already been harvesting them off of here. There are, just look at that. Look in here. I mean, there are so many tomatoes in here. I mean, I've never had tomato plants with this many tomatoes. And this plant goes all over the place. It's crazy. So I didn't really prune them very well and guide them up. I just let them, you know, branch off and vine everywhere. But I'll tell you what, we're going to get a big harvest off those. So we're excited about that. Best year we've ever had for peppers. I'm growing three different kinds. We've got bell peppers, cayenne peppers, and banana peppers. And you can see some of the banana peppers here ready to be pickled. I'm going to grab a bunch of these probably... Oh, if I have time today or tomorrow. Absolutely beautiful. These bell peppers, this is some of our smaller ones. You can see some bell peppers in here. But these have been just growing amazing. I've got a bunch of other peppers here. This is a cayenne. So you can see a bunch of those on there. We've got a bunch of huge ones. But we've been able to get, one or two bell peppers almost every day off of all these. And we've got some more over here too. The peas did very well. It's too hot for them now, and they didn't get watered while we were on vacation, so they are starting to die back, and we barely harvested. I just didn't have the time this year. It was gone and moving and all the things to do, so I mean, it went crazy, but yeah, the chickens will eat them. So you know what? Sometimes gardening is a mess. But they grew very well, and if we would have had a chance to get out here and harvest them, there's still a lot to harvest, but we wasted a lot of them, unfortunately. This was potatoes, which have already been harvested. Huge potato harvest out of that bed. I would say the red skin potatoes, the smaller ones, probably probably 40, 45 pounds out of this bed here. This is ready to be harvested. Potato plants just all died back. Obviously there's weeds in here now, but we'll just pull that right out. I'm gonna harvest those today. Potatoes in here as well. Those have died back, so they're ready to harvest. And again, we haven't had a chance to weed in here, so the weeds just sprout right up as soon as those potatoes died back. Some smaller stuff in here, it's just some carrots and some different kinds of beans in the front, and then all of our bell peppers along the back. These are our big producers. Let's see if I can find a good size bell pepper in here. Well, there's some littler ones, it looks like. We've been making salsa, so I've been out here stealing them as much as I can. But these two plants right here, this one and I believe this one, these two plants are 3 years old. These were in our aquaponic system. They were moved in and out a couple times and moved around, and the aquaponic system is torn down right now. I moved them out of the aquaponic system, planted them in the garden early this year, and we've already gotten probably 7 massive bell peppers off of each one of these plants. They have just been awesome. And so these, I don't know how long they'll last, but I'm gonna keep overwintering these two. These are like my buddies. We're gonna keep overwintering those and see how many years we can get those to produce, and they'll keep getting bigger and bigger every year. More peas here. These ones are dead. And a lot of people have asked about these invisible trellises. You know, I did a video on that. We're using the fishing line, but how strong they are. And we're growing these sugar baby watermelons, and you can see them hanging here. They've grown just fine. There was a couple more we already harvested, and they hang all that weight hangs all across those fishing lines with no problem. So, you know, this fishing line is tough, and it doesn't cut through the vines because they're intertwined between a bunch of pieces of fishing line. So it's not hanging from one piece. It hangs from the whole thing together, and they seem to be fine. So, you know, anybody who had that concern, don't worry about it. Over here, more banana peppers. Those are beyond ready to harvest. This bed was all peanuts originally, and the peanuts did not do so well. I don't know what happened. I don't know if it was transplanting. I don't know if it was, I don't know what it was. There's still, I don't know. There's still a peanut plant right there. There's a couple in here. I might dig up to see if there's one right there. They just, I don't know much about growing peanuts. That was an experiment this year. So, no luck on that. I had onions. This bed was filled with onions, and unfortunately, I let the weeds get too high. By the time I weeded them, they were too small and lanky, and then we were gone. Nothing got watered that dried out, and most of them died. So unfortunately, no good onions this year, but hey, we're in the middle of moving, like I said, so it is what it is. Got some raspberries in there, I see. This is what I call my tomato forest. There are tomato plants that were supported that fell over. There are some that I didn't have a chance to support, but look at all of those tomatoes, you guys. Look at those. Look at all the tomatoes in here. I mean, I'm talking, I couldn't even count, hundreds of tomatoes in here. It's amazing. A lot of them are getting eaten. You can see, look on the ground there, a little bunny. I see him coming in here, nibbling on all their stuff. But we'll share a few with them. So this is the tomato forest back here, but it's also the sunflower forest, and this is the area that gets the most sun. So these sunflowers, these Russian mammoth sunflowers, are just insanely huge. This one right here, and it is growing out of a raised bed, so it's a foot higher off the ground than the rest, but look at that thing. It is just, probably 12 feet tall. I bet you it's even taller than that, honestly. And it's not done yet. And look at the size of the trunk on this thing. I mean, this thing is just huge. Look at this thing. I had to support it because it's the roots aren't real deep in these raised beds, but this was just kind of an extra one I threw in here. But it's split, which I've never seen with these mammoth sunflowers before. So it's got two heads on it. Hopefully it'll last once it gets the weight of the sunflower seeds on there. I don't know if it'll last or not, but I'll take you through here if I can get through without stepping on too many tomatoes. One pumpkin this year. And the tomatoes kind of shaded it out in here. I didn't have a chance to stake these up. But man, look at all these tomatoes. I got to get some of these up off the ground. And there's quite a few that are ready. We are just going to have to go crazy with tomatoes. Just everywhere. Some good sized Romas in here too. And of course our chickens back here. Now I have been letting the chickens out through the garden. They did pretty well, but you can see they did kind of trample through on some of the tomato plants and stuff. So I don't know. I'm gonna have to find a way to tie these up a little bit more, keep the tomatoes off the ground. But I've also got, just really quickly, I've got stuff growing up here that, you know, this is all kind of herbs. I've got some flowers for the bees, and this is a strawberry patch in here. Not a lot of strawberries this year, though. I don't know if it's from the just being too hot, not enough water, or what, but some container tomatoes here. Those are just extras as well. These are some beefsteaks. Or some hybrids, I can't even remember. I never really label these things too much. But these are doing really well. I mean, look at all those. Just bunches of tomatoes. They were so heavy, the stake. I mean, there's no way I could hold those up with the little stakes I had and twisty ties. So, loaded with and a random like corn stalk over here. And the orange tree up there on the back, it comes out, the clementine tree, it comes out in the summer, and it's doing well. There's a few clementines on there, so that's pretty much the garden. I know this video went a little longer than I normally do. I normally try to stay under 10 minutes, but I wanted to take you guys through and show you what we have. I have a few videos coming out on the garden in the next week or two. I'm going to talk about raised beds versus traditional gardening. I've done both. And just kind of my thoughts on that. We'll go through some of the harvests and things we get as well, and talk a little bit about those things. But even though the garden has become an overgrown, kind of weedy food forest, I guess you could say, it's been fun. And there's so much to growing in here, and it's kind of fun to just kind of, you know, barrel through the growth and find ripe food ready to eat. We've just been having a ball with this stuff. So it's time for me to harvest some potatoes. And y'all have a great day, and we'll see you guys on the next video.